There is, in reality, only one true hydroponic growing media out there, and it's called, wait for it, water. Ha! What? That's right, good old H2O. So it's the minerals dissolved into your water that actually nourish your hydroponic plants. You knew that already, but I just wanted to underline the fact that it's definitely not the stonewool, perlite, clay balls, or grow stones doing the work. After all, this stuff is inert. It kind of acts like a nutrient carrier, but contains no nutrition in and of itself like soil does. In fact, the purest form of hydroponics, water culture, grows plants with their roots directly submerged in well-oxygenated and temperature-controlled nutrient solution. No soil or any other stuff required. Why am I telling you this? Well, surely it begs the question, if hydroponics is the science of growing plants directly in a nutrient-rich solution, what's the deal with all these bags of stuff taking up space in your local grow store? Again, I'm not referring to soil-based potting mixes here. I'm pointing my finger at those big sacks of hydroponic growing media such as coconut coir, perlite, expanded clay balls, stone wool, peat moss, grow stones, and soilless mixes. Welcome, my inquisitive amigos, to the wonderful world of hydroponic growing media. The main reason why so many hydroponic growers choose to spend money on hydroponic growing media is because they enjoy the buffer of moisture and nutrients should a pump fail. It also affords their plants some physical stability and provides some thermal insulation for the roots. Arguably, by using growing media, you enjoy a wider margin for error as you grow. Any growing media out there has dozens of characteristics, but in practice, you really just need to know about three: WHC, AFP, and CEC, or in non-gratuitous acronym language, water holding capacity, how much nutrient solution it can absorb, air-filled porosity, the amount of airspace in the media, and cation exchange capacity, how readily the growing media can hold onto and release positive ions to the roots. So, water holding capacity, or WHC, is really a measure of how absorbent or restrictive a material is. For example, Mother Earth coconut coir and Grodan Growwool are two examples of highly absorbent or restrictive growing media. They can hold between 5 and 8 times their own weight in water. Because they hold onto so much nutrient solution, they need to be irrigated less often. On the other end of the WHC spectrum are hydroton expanded clay balls, available from Mother Earth in regular or giant size. They absorb relatively little water and as such require very regular irrigation, even constant dripping. They're virtually impossible to overwater, so they're easy to use. And in the middle of the WHC road are Mother Earth grow stones, which absorb moderate amounts of nutrient solution while still affording good drainage. Air-filled porosity is important because roots like oxygen or air gaps in order to respire effectively. Most coconut coir products, for instance, are not screened, allowing fibers to get through. And for good reason. These fibers really help to keep air in the mix. Remember, the smaller the particles in any growing media, the more moisture it can hold. Perlite is often added to soilless mixes such as Mother Earth Coco Coir and Perlite or Vermipro because of its high AFP. It basically helps to increase drainage and air supply in the rhizosphere. Now finally, cation exchange capacity. A low CEC means the medium doesn't hold on to nutrients easily. Stone wool or rock wool has a low CEC, making it very easy to control what's available to the plant. This is particularly handy toward the end of the cycle when it's time to flush it with pure water. Coconut coir, on the other hand, has a high CEC within its cellulose and traps cations such as potassium, calcium, magnesium, iron, manganese, copper, zinc, and boron. These ions are subsequently exchanged for other ions in the solution, so don't worry, they're not trapped forever. Special coco coir specific nutrient formulations are available which exploit the unique characteristics of this media. Now do check out peat-based soilless potting mixes such as Classman TS4 with medium perlite. Peat offers a great home for beneficial biology if you swing that way. Other stuff to consider? Cost. Obviously, note, this can vary dramatically depending on where you happen to be in the world. Is it renewably resourced? Reusability is another key issue, as well as biodegradability. Is it easy to handle? Does it require any special preparations such as pre-soaking or washing to remove particulates or stabilize pH? For more information, do check out my article, Grow Media 101 at justforgrowers.com. I've included the link in the description below. Obviously, I'll be getting busy with lots of different growing media, so we'll deal with each in turn in our follow-up videos soon. Don't forget to subscribe so that you get notified when I upload more videos. This is Everest out.